The one thing I feel guilty of is that I'm not the guy that like gets an orgasm off of vinyl. Mm-hmm. Now, as a
I know a lot about you. I mean, I thought, feel like I should learn so much more.
I thought you did. I thought that was your thing.
Yeah, you and Steve together.
What else? No, I'm just saying that it's. I mean, for a guy that relentlessly collects records and all those things, like I don't have
audiophile guy.
Yeah, what's the turntable in the lobby right now?
Macintosh,
like a Macintosh. Mm-hmm. Like I've yet to get a Mac. Do you own a Macintosh?
Not a Macintosh turntable, but I do have the amplifiers. Yeah, the so turntable is a little too expensive.
Does that truly make a difference to you, or?
I think that what goes on in it, to me, there's the MacGuffin of whether the format is 8-track tapes or cassettes or vinyl. I think vinyl is just the most viable thing that everyone can kind of get around to with the large artwork and the large object. Just trying to be reverential to music itself, mm-hmm. like a movie theater and a 7mm mm-hmm. film. Mm-hmm. Going in there, closing the door, turning the lights off, the curtain opens, and we watch a film. We actually, in 2018, we all get off our ass and we drive to a theater mm-hmm. and sit down in silence, turn our phones off, and in the dark watch a movie. That's incredible we're still doing that. Mm-hmm. I just want that same reverence for music. So the vinyl part, you know, if it's 8-track or cassettes or whatever it is, I just like that it's something you can hold
tangible,
in your hand.
Something tangible, yeah.
Yeah. And I also think that when it comes to the way, you know, I say we travel and stuff, of course, I'm not bringing a turntable backstage and setting it up. I'm listening on an iPod or we're listening in someone's phone, going through Beats Pill or something like that, doing whatever we can.
Wait, you have a phone now?
I don't have a phone, no. someone Whoa, someone else's phone.
I thought the world was
phone,
coming to an end. I was like, wait a minute, I thought you don't own phones.
So you still don't own no cell phone?
I right? don't, no. But the
all the family lucky members, you. Would you?
I'm like, how did they reach you?
I'm sorry.
Nah, that's real, though. That's real as fuck.
I do mostly just emails is how I communicate. That way I can walk away from it. I can sit down and do it and walk away.
Must be nice.
I'm sorry. I know you were making another point, but when did you get to this point where you were allowed to do that? Because you know that's a luxury.
Yeah, oh my God.
Yeah.
Don't think people around me, it doesn't drive them crazy.
What?
It drives them crazy. But it's just sort of I think that it's just one of those things for me personally. I'm not preaching to other people. You know? For me personally, I can't do that because I will be on it all day long.
Yeah.
It will not stop. And there's just so much going on in my world that I don't really want to be a slave to that. It'll just consume my life. And
yes, it will.
It's nice to be, like, I think, you know, it's an interesting thing. I can give you an example of my kids. We had a family car, and the first... We had the same car for the first like 7 years that they were growing up. We would take long trips from Nashville to Detroit and stuff like that.
Your actual kids?
Yes.
I thought you meant childhood.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Your kids.
How old are they?
They're 10 and 11 now.
Okay, gotcha.
Let's say for the first 7 years we had this family car, and this car had a DVD player in it that we never told them about. And they would point to this thing in the ceiling. What is that, Dad? I'm like, oh, that's just something for the air conditioner. And my point wasn't to deprive them of whatever. It was just to like that imagination time where you get to really think and look out the window. And just that's the time where you really start to imagine the best things in life.
See, you're not the dad that let like the Little Mermaid babysit your kids so that you
oh, no.
get silence.
No.
They don't have iPads.
Yo, dude, I admire that shit. Oh. Like I'll go to Sunday brunch restaurants and I'll just see a bunch of kids.
Yeah. It's nice to be able to. Well, it's like I remember like working when all the jobs I've had, the best music ideas I think were me, whatever it was, making a you know a pizza at the restaurant or bussing a table or working on a piece of furniture. That's when I'm like, oh man, when I get home, that's what I gotta do. I gotta put reverb on that a snare drum when I get home. That'll
give you time to think.
That's this time where you have the best ideas. Suprema.